in honor of Independence Day weekend.
And this great country of America, here is my custom scrimshod. I did okay, shrub crafters. Gonna try to beat the rain today. Independence weekend. Supposed to be raining. Skies are a little ominous. Bugs were down for a few, but they're just starting to kick back in, of course. I'm going to try to chronograph the 36 cal Shenandoah with that 20 grain load and see where we're hitting. It's been working great on the red squirrels up here. And I'm trying to get everything found, all my information found out before hunting season. I want to use it on rabbit. I don't think there'll be any problem taking down rabbit. Don't think there's any problem taking down coyote with it, although I think with a little stouter load on a 36 would do a little more. The 20 really does come out there pretty hot. But for coyote, I don't think so. So unfortunately, my other camera is down right now. Memory card isn't working right. So I'm going to have the one. I've got a tripod set up over here. I'm gonna try to shoot over it and see what we can do and see what I can do with this camera and getting some data for you. I am preloaded 20 grains, Pyrodex 3F and caps. That's the squirrel load I've been using, and see what happens. And this has been loaded up for probably 4 weeks now. And here we go. 1071, that's 20 grains, 3F, 36 cal ball. So I'll do the math later, where you can go on like Dillon Blue Press. They've got a converter. So all you gotta do is put in your velocity and everything, but I'll just do the math. But 1071 coming out of here, that's zinging along pretty good. I mean, that's 22 cal. Easily, and that's pushing a 36 cal, so I mean I wouldn't have any qualms of shooting that in anything. So I'm gonna load up again and we'll do that a couple more times and get an average.
All right, shot number two.
Going for shot number three. .1167. So I was a hair shy, I think on the second one for powder. I double checked my measure and I was a hair short of the line. .1167. I'll tell you what, I can't speak enough of this Pro Chrono. Is awesome. So I'm gonna do two more, get a five shot group, and we'll get an average. Whew. Nice. It's crazy. That one felt hotter. 1272. It's a little weird. I double check my measure. Interesting. Just a hair over the line. But definitely awesome. So I'm gonna do one more. All right. Number five. 1224. There you go. 1224. That is a perfect, perfect, perfect representation. I was a little leery of black powder over this, but we've got an overcast day and the range holding out. And there you have it. So we've got, let's see, $12.24, $12.72, $11.67, $10.59, and $10.71. All right, we're gonna do 40 grains of 3F, see what happens. $18.11. That's 40 grains, 3F. Well, let's just see here. So, I know a lime in Great Plains, you know, you can do 120 in a 50. And so I would say, you know, if you think it's a 36, 50 would be 100 in a 50 cal if you double, it's 100. So I know my Blue Ridge tells me 72 grains in a 50 to 80 grains, you know, ballpark. So in a 36, you should be able to do 70 grains, right? Let's just do 70 grains once, see what happens, and get a velocity. Okay, 70 grains, we'll get a velocity on that. $23.06. And gun's no worse for the wear. I mean, it's a barrel steel on this is pretty darn thick. It's got thicker walls than a 50 does. $23.06. That actually felt really good. Like my 20 load seems almost anemic anyway when you're shooting. But for squirrel, I mean, it's perfect. There's almost no meat damage because you're not expanding that lead going through the squirrel, which is really, really nice. That 70 grains, that's got some oomph to it. Doesn't hurt, doesn't kick. So phenomenal, phenomenal, absolutely phenomenal. So let's see. This 2306. I'm going to switch over. So definitely, you know, 70 grains, easily doable. That's got enough energy out there. We'll do the calculations once I get home, but you've got plenty of energy out there.